बी रेडी, 5 सेकेंड्स, स्टार्ट. सर, आई राइज टू सपोर्ट द बजट विच हैज बीन प्रेजेंटेड बाय द फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर फॉर द ईयर 2002-2003. द बजट इज बोल्ड, इनोवेटिव एंड प्रैग्मेटिक इन इंट्रोड्यूसिंग मैनी स्टेप्स फॉर रिस्टोरिंग द इकोनॉमी टू इट्स प्रॉपर पाथ. We have got to see why this budgetary policy was introduced. This house knows what was the economic scenario at the time when the present government came to power in June 1991. The economy was going to be bankrupt in the international sphere. Our reserves of foreign exchange for the imports were not even for 2 weeks' requirements. Internationally, the world was not at all giving any credibility to the Indian economy, and the foreign banks stopped lending money to India. The NRIs were withdrawing their deposits because they had lost confidence in the Indian economy. That was the position which was being brought about by the 18 months rule, and in 11 months the government of the National Front had brought the economy to such a position that the inflation in the country reached its high water mark in July 1997 at 16%. The government have to face this impending crisis because if the international banks and institutions stop supplying funds to India, what will be our position, our credibility before the world? Faced with this situation, the government took the bold step of devaluation and took certain important immediate measures for restoring the economic strength and vitality of our country. The result is that the present position is that the foreign exchange reserves of our country have increased to ₹12,000 crores. We are not too dependent upon charity now because we have our own strength of our foreign exchange reserves. The inflation is arrested. It cannot be reduced overnight. Economic reforms cannot be made by the magic wand of only the finance minister. The budgetary policy only can create certain conditions to which economy has to respond, and the response cannot be made like the Aladdin's lamp overnight, and hence we have got to wait for the results of the policy which has been introduced by the finance minister. We have to see today what are the objectives that the government had in view for introducing the various measures, some of which are really innovative and beneficial to our economy. The objective before the government was to tide over the crisis in the balance of payments position and at the same time to control the inflation in the country. The twin objectives were achieved by the government by introducing our new industrial policy, monetary policy, trade policy and fiscal policy as well. The budgetary policy reflects the economic philosophy. The fiscal policy of the government, and the government thought, and rightly so, that if the economy is to be restored from its impasse, one of the major objectives will be to liberalize the economy and to unshackle the economy from the cobwebs of bureaucratic control. It is precisely because of this reason that the new industrial policy, excepting in certain basic sectors, has now freed the economy from the licensing and other requirements which created artificial bottlenecks in developing the country on its own. The finance minister has introduced various measures to give relief to the different sectors of the economy. He has introduced a drastic cut in the rate of taxation. Today, there are only 3 slabs of income tax. The people whose income is up to ₹50,000 are to pay 20%. The people whose income is between ₹50,000 and 1 lakh are to pay 30%, and for above ₹1 lakh, it will be only 40% with a surcharge which, as assured by the finance minister, will continue only for 1 year. He has also raised the taxation exemption limit from ₹22,000 to ₹28,000. In other words, the small income group will get a relief of ₹6,000 as their tax exemption limit is increased. I would appeal to the finance minister to see whether this raising of the exemption limit will really give substantial relief to the middle or the lower income groups in our country. The finance minister has introduced a better liquidity on the basis of the recommendations of Narasimham Committee. The liquidity ratio is to be reduced from 38% to 30%. It is a very welcome measure, for the commercial banks are not to keep much of their deposits locked up in unproductive investments. Now they have been released, and this will give encouragement to the investment in productive sectors. The finance minister has introduced a very important measure for dealing with inflation and evasion of taxes. He is giving encouragement for the gold bond, which he will be introducing, as he has announced. As a result of this unnecessary locking up of gold for non-productive purposes will be done away with.